Hello, Odooers, and welcome back. Have you been looking for the best way to improve your products? Well, look no further, because I'm about to show you how to use Product Lifecycle Management, also known as PLM in Odoo. So what is PLM? Think of it as a systematic approach to testing, collaborating on, and improving products. First up, we have the design phase. This is where new products are introduced or revisions to existing products are proposed. The most promising ones are the ones we move forward with. Next up, we have the development phase. This is where we actually finalize designs, create and test prototypes, and get feedback on the product. Once the design phase is complete, production can finally start. All the while, we identify our audience and plan how to introduce this product to the market. Following production is the service phase. This is when companies offer services like post-sale services and maintenance and collect feedback to keep in mind for future versions. And last, we have the product's end life. In this stage, products are withdrawn from the market and the brainstorming cycle begins all over again. When it's done right, PLM brings all of your departments together in perfect harmony. It's really a collaborative process, which we're fans of, since it means all of our products are tried and true before they hit the market and customers finally see it. What's cool too is PLM also features version control, meaning we can create engineering change orders, or ECOs, for any iteration of a product and can easily roll it back to a previously stable version if we need to, in case the latest version needs some updates. Okay, now that we know how PLM works, let's check it out in our Odoo database and see exactly what we can do with ECOs. Before we get started with the PLM application, let me show you a few things on the bill of materials for the wood shelf, which is the product that we'll be using today. When I go to the miscellaneous tab, I can see that the BoM has a version number. This is the first iteration of the product, and if formal changes to the BoM are made through an ECO, the version number will also change. I also have a file attached to this BoM with the design for the first version of our wooden shelf. Now that we've reviewed our product, let's jump into the PLM app where we can manage ECOs. ECOs, or engineering change orders, are documents used to manage product revisions. Here on our PLM overview page, we see cards for each of our different ECO types. For today's example, I don't want to create a new product. Instead, I want to update an existing product. So I'll show you how to create another ECO type quickly. We're going to do so by going to Configuration and ECO Types. We'll create a new ECO type called Product Updates. I can also create an email alias over here, so when someone has a new idea for a product update, they can send it to this email alias and a brand new task card will show up in this ECO's pipeline. I'll show you that pipeline in just a bit. Let's type in updates in the email alias field so people know what this email is for. Then let's head back into the PLM overview. And boom, we see that a new ECO type has just been created. I'm gonna go ahead and change the color of the Kanban card too, so it's easier to differentiate between the different ECO types. Okay, now we have a bit of an Odoo jargon warning. We'll now create stages to track the progress of tasks throughout the product lifecycle. The purpose of stages in the PLM pipeline is to create new tasks, whether it be for new product ideas, revisions, or fixes, and keep track of collaborative process as we make progress on each ECO that we're working on. I'm going to go ahead and create four stages: new, in progress, approved, and effective. Now, let's go ahead and add managerial approval to one of our stages. I'm going to go ahead and add it to the approved stage. Makes sense, right? When I head to the edit stage, I have the option to add mandatory approval from another employee. I'm going to go ahead and add my engineering director, Mitchell Admin, as the required approver. For approval type, I can make the approval mandatory, optional, or comments only. Since I want the engineering director to review the product changes before the team applies them, I'll keep this approval mandatory. I'd also like to make a quick note that you must include the user and approval type here in order for this to work. Let's go ahead and edit our last stage so that Odoo knows it's the last stage in our ECO pipeline. I'll indicate that I want changes to be applied in this stage. This means that once an ECO reaches this stage, I'll be able to actually apply the product revisions that we were working on in the previous stages, and the new version of whatever product I'm working on will take effect, with the old one being archived. You'll see what I mean soon. I'll also mark this as the final stage and have it folded in the Kanban view. Awesome. Now that all of our stages are configured, let's go ahead and start a new engineering change order. I'm going to go ahead and make updates on the wooden shelf, and we'll call this version 2. Let's double check that I have the correct ECO type selected, which is product updates. Next, I want to select my product, which is the wood shelf. I can also choose which specific bill of materials I want to change if I have multiple, but in this case, I only have one BoM, so we're okay. I also need to select when I want my changes to take effect. I'm going to go ahead and select today's date. Under the notes section, I can describe my desired changes. Let's say that we've received feedback on this product and customers want 3 shelves instead of 2. I'm going to go ahead and add another plank and increase operation time by 30 minutes. Now we can start the revision. All of this looks good, so let's go ahead and move our ECO to the in-progress stage and start working on it. We see that there's already one document linked here, which is the shelf's version 1 design that was already attached to the BoM. Perfect. Now, Odooers, watch this. To update my product's design, I can upload a new document directly over here. And I can archive the old design by selecting remove. So easy. Now let's go back to the ECO via the breadcrumbs and take a look at the revision. Using the smart button right over here, revision V2. Now this revision isn't active yet, which is why it has the archived flag on it. When we check under the miscellaneous tab, we'll see that the product's version is number 2. So let's start our revision by incorporating our changes directly on this version 2 BoM. First, I'll add an additional walnut plank to the components and change it to 3. Oopsie, I meant 3. Now, my workers have to install an additional plank, so I'll head to the Operations tab and increase the duration of my operation by 30 minutes. Let's go ahead and change this to 90. And save. Awesome. Going back to my ECO, 2 new tabs have appeared as a result of the changes that we made. In the BoM changes tab over here, we can see that I've increased the quantity of the walnut planks by 1. In the operations tab, I've changed the operation time from 60 minutes to 90 minutes. Everything looks great, so let's move this to the approved stage. Now take a look at this, Odooers. When the ECO is moved to the approval stage, an activity is automatically generated for Mitchell Admin in the chatter. This is because we configured Mitchell Admin as an approver when we created the stage. So let's pretend we're Mitchell Admin. I'll go ahead and mark this ECO as approved, and then we'll mark this activity as done. All right, we're almost finished. Now that these product updates are approved, we'll go ahead and move it to the effective stage. Before we apply our changes, let's review the product versions. Here's the original bill of materials for the wood shelf. And I like the changes that we made for the version 2 BoM. Now, let's go back to the ECO, and I'll apply the changes that we've made. Now, when I review the original BoM, we can see that it's marked as archived. And when I take a look at the revision, we can see that it's now active. Now that we've formally applied our changes, this V2 version of the bill of materials will be used from here on out until another engineering change order is established. And that brings us to the end of this video. Check out our other videos to learn even more about product changes. Other than that, thanks for watching, Odooers. See you next time.